Anyways, a Cho'Gall, better cry on next spell you play, cast this turn cost for health instead of mana. It consists with the Warlock's hero power or the theme. And free mana card? Good! Doom, destroy all minions, draw a card for each. You can play that for 10 health instead and draw a card for Cho'Gall as well. I think it's a really, really interesting and amazing mechanic. I just don't know if a 7 mana 7/7 is strong enough. Hopefully, your health, you have high enough health that it shouldn't matter. The spell, extra spell that you play for free mana is gonna be impactful enough, hopefully. It actually might as well be, like, even if you cast a 2 mana card for 2 health, 5 mana 7/7. Boom! Not bad. I just don't know if you need the draw mechanic displayed as a warlock, because you should be also worrying about your own health and fatigue. It's just good alternation to Twisting Nether, but costs more. Like I said, I draw at that turn 10. Unless your health is in danger and you don't want to use your hero power, it's not really concerned, so I don't see this card being too impactful. Anyways, Renounce Darkness. Replace your hero power and warlock cards with the another class's cards cost one less. What? Replace your hero power and warlock cards with another class's. This actually, even if, oh my god. Random, I guess. Wow. A value card? You can start Handlock and go Warrior. Very intriguing. Cards cost one less, so it pays for itself. It's a late game card that costs a ship, possibly. You can draw crap ton with the hand as warlock, renounce your darkness, and go boom. I assume you can play your hero power as well, so you can either be really, really, you know, you can just go random hunter, deal 10 damage to face, or heal yourself, or become even a warrior. All cost one less. I really, really like this card. This card depends on how you use it and how, if there's enough synergy of cards being drawn. Although I keep saying that third cards are bad, third cards are mediocre, third cards are good. But with the one less cost, unless you have to worry about value and draws, all those two-thirds of cards are amazing. One-third of cards are mediocre. Even those mediocre cards might be not bad. Just situational. As long as you don't get too many situational cards, that doesn't help you that much in that particular case, which is unlikely to happen as long as you have enough class cards. I can definitely see this being used often. Spreading the Madness, deal 9 damage randomly split among all characters for 3 mana. In average, you're dealing 4.5 damage to random character on your opponent's board. Well, that is under assumption you have the same number of minions, which wouldn't be true. I don't like the card. I don't know if it's A, can lose you games instantly. B, I don't know if it'll make too much impact on board. It's 3 mana, but wouldn't you rather have a 2 damage AoE than this card that doesn't hurt you or your minions because your minions are demons? I mentioned this before. Most of aggression are being rotated out, in my opinion. With the exception of Zoo, if that might be even rotated down. Or being slowed down, what I meant to say is not rotated out. Temple Mage and Face Shaman. Face Shaman does not suffer from this too much because all their minions are actually beefy for its cost. Same goes for Mage. A lot of their minions are beefy for its cost, so deal 9 damage randomly across spread all characters is not gonna be too helpful in my opinion. Especially you're dealing damage to yourself with it. We'll have to see if there are any synerging or if there's a way to deal 9 damage to enemy face, for example. That'll be quite interesting. Possess a villager, death roll, summon 1/1 shadow beast. Oh my god, so it's like that Argent Squire. It's like Argent Squire, but death rattle instead of divine shield. I can't really think of death roll synerging warlock cards. No comment on this. It's just another alternative. It's also class card, so I guess renounce darkness will be helpful with this. But then you're not really running those early 1/1s anyways as mid-range or late-game warlocks as of yet. So maybe it will come into the future, but not as of yet. Darkswear Librarian. Battlecry, discard a random card. Deathrattle, draw a card. Discard and draw. Is a mechanic that often used in other cards or card games. Not good. Not good. Not good. Discard a random card. Alright, if there are no Doomguards in Zudek, this card will be played. But since there are Doomguards in Zudek, nope. Forbidden Ritual, spend all your mana, summon that many 1/1 tentacles. What the hell? Oh my god. Unleash. Game over. What is this? Alright, so not strong enough to be played for heavy cards, but then is it good enough to be played in early game or like for... No, it's not. Implosion way better. No, I don't think this card makes a cut either. Many 0 mana cards will give you 1-1 mana efficiency because of how effective it is. But unless you have extra mana compared to your opponent, like the Druid will, if you Wild Growth, you will have 1 extra mana always. So Wild Growth, if you play on turn 2, will give you 6 extra mana, 7 extra mana or so, over next 7 turns. But without those mechanics, I don't think it's effective enough or strong enough. Not to mention 1-1 tentacles, 1-1 minions and 1-1 tokens on board is not particularly amazing. Usher of Souls, whenever a friendly minion dies, give your Cthulhu +1/+1. Oh my god, 5 and a 5/6. Yo, definitely good enough to make a cut for 5 drop. But then Warlock Cthulhu deck, I don't know if it doesn't have enough removals, right? Like Warlock rely a lot on surviving with the 2-3 drops, removals, and minions that you play. There's a lot of strong 2 drops existing out there already that everybody plays. But then if you remove them and give good mid-range decks, mid-range cards instead, is that good enough? I don't think so, personally. I actually think removing those 2 drops for Kithin cards will kill the deck. Because you'd rather play Handlock than, like, you'd rather play 8-8 for 4 mana than 5 mana, 5-6. It's how I say it as of now. Darkshroud Councilman, after you summon a minion, +1 attack. It's 3 mana. Again, one of the silence, and then your tucked card. But it's beefy enough. Even if it's 2-5, as long as you play a minion, it's really good. Question is whether you can play it with the other cards. The answer likely is yes, if you're playing Stormy deck. Zoo deck. I think it'll be a new 3-drop in Zoo deck, because the Zoo decks don't really have 3-drop that are particularly amazing. But this card is amazing, you have to kill this one. And Zoo decks with the Void Walkers have a not bad, and Defender Warriors, not bad. Defender Warriors will make this card 3-5 taunt instead of 2-5, so... I think this card will be one of the backbone cards for early mid game, early mid decks.
Hey guys, Masan here, thanks for watching. Please join my channel by clicking this subscribe button and check out more of my videos right here. I appreciate your support, you're awesome, stay beautiful, Masan out.